Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Enjoy Your Fishing. I'm just about to start a session in Arts Home Park.
What time is it?
It's 1 o'clock. It's been bright sun all morning. It's just started to cloud over a bit, so hopefully I might get one later. Got lots of feeder matches coming up, and I have over the next month, including the feeder national on the Trent. So I thought I'd just come down, and as you know, I like to practice anyway. What I'm going to do is I've got two really thin tall trees just to my right a little bit, so I'm going to put six of them in that line. I am food free offerings. All I've got with me is, I mean, I have got some worm in my bag, but before I introduce worm, I like to just give it an hour first, and then if I feel I need to introduce worm, I will do. I've got some big red maggots with me and big fluoros. I've got some pinkies and casters, and I've got some micro pellets. So I'm just going food micro pellets. I'm using braid on this line as well. I am. I'm not squeezing it in too tight. I'm not, because it's only a shallow lake. It's only like 3 to 4 foot. So I've got one or two areas where it's nearly 5 foot, but generally it's like in between 3 and 4 foot. I'm not putting my feed exactly on the sixpence, because I just want to lay some down there, and then if I leave it for a while, I can just go out on a small feeder and hopefully something will be grazing. Because the carp lads fish this for big carp, and I put quite a few boilies in and pellets. I am putting a few micros in, and I've also got some of the boilie crush in. in my ground bait as well. Right, I'll put one more in there. No, I'll leave that now for probably an hour. Although it doesn't seem a lot of ground bait, it is when you know, it'll cover a good area out there. Change that for that little cage feeder,
that rocket style feeder. It's a Nisa feeder, that is.
I've already got milk out. Just size 14 and 30. No, sorry, that's LWGF, the Guru one. Feeder special. And that's 2.14 fluorocarbon. I like to use fluorocarbon. Right. My other line as I said, because the carp lads fish this with boilies and that. I'm gonna fish a method as well today. I've got micro pellets underneath that. I've got my sweet fish meal ground bait on top of it, and I've got a yellow wafter underneath that. Right, and what I'm gonna do, with this, is just chuck this to me, not quite out in front of me, but just a little bit to the left. I've got my stopwatch, so I've got a couple of 15 minute casts. And we'll see if we can get one. On my method rod, I'm only using 8 pound mono, it's the Suffolk Green Advance. So that's all I'm using. No point in using braid on a method, I don't think, because if I get a bite, it's just going to go anyway. Okay, talk to you soon, guys, hopefully, if I get one. Hi guys, I had an hour on the method and I've just gone on to this and I've got a perch. First put in. There we go, got a perch. Here we go. So at least I'm not water leaked. Which is always a possibility when you come here. And that's alright, at least we've had a fish. Not really what I'm after, one of them big bream, but at least we've had one. Just leave that on there a minute for you, on the tip. See if it goes. There we go. It's 2 hours now I've been fishing, guys, and I've still only had them two perch. I had one little tap after that. So I ain't had another bite on that short line. So what I've done, I've decided to, this is my first cast on this, on my long line, which I had the method on. I've decided to change that to a conventional feeder as well. Just see if we can get a bite on that. And fishing more into the open bit of the lake in that one. If I don't get a bite, with in sort of 20 minutes of fishing this line, any indications are out, I'm going to start introducing worm on that line. Just a bite on worm, guys. I got some on. I'm not sure. It might be an eel, I think.
Is
it seems to be fighting like a bream anyway. It's an eel, that is the way that's shaking its head. Go on, you can bite me off if you want. Oh, will you behave? Here we go. He didn't want to come in.
What a lovely fish though. Look at that. What a lovely fish. Come here, mate.
Got the hook back. There's a couple of pounds. Got something else on now, guys. Don't know what it is, but it snagged it up then. Well, I've saved him. Straighten the hook. Never mind. Look at that. It's not my line, that isn't. I don't know what it is. Don't know what that was. There we go, look. One of the carp lads, look. The fuck is all that? Thank you. No wonder that eel felt weird. Look at all that round my bloody feeder. God knows what breaking strain that is. Pleased I caught that eel.
It's rescued it anyway, hasn't it?
God knows how long that's been carrying that around with it. Yeah, on a day when it's been really warm. And at times there hasn't been a cloud in the sky. It's been a really strange day. So going into the last hour. Two eels and two perch.
Can't believe that.
Just look at that. Shouldn't be allowed, should it? I mean, if that was a carp or a... bream... it'd be dead by now. Because it would never have got off that hook. Here he is, look. Can you see him? There he is. Don't know what this is. Another eel, I should think.
Yeah, I think it's an eel.
Let's see if we can go in. I don't think so, but... No, it's took it
too far down. So what we'll do is we'll just go like that,
and a lot of the time the hook will straighten and come out when it's a finer wire. Right, it didn't do that time, but it's better than. Ramming a hook, ramming a disgorger too deep. Try 3 dead reds on my short line. Thank you. Another eel, I think.
It's a double, yeah.
Huh. Lots of things.
Dropped himself around the line.
Oh, nice eel, look. Well, I don't know. Hook come out of that one anyway, straighten the hook. can get one. That's four eels. Robin sat in me pinkies. I would call this the last one, guys. It's another eel, I think. Yeah. Only about a pound, that one. Show you. That'll do. Oh, we'll call that the last one. So that's five eels and two perch. At least we had a few bites. All right, guys. Oh, I'll show you the eels that I've got. Good weight there. There you go, look. Two perch. And five eels. Very nice. So yeah, I'd say there's a good £10 there. So yeah. Here we go, guys, look at them. Lovely fish, look. Hey, what a lovely fish. Let's go and pop that foot. Oh, that's not bad, really, considering what sort of day it's been. You know, wind's been all over the place, and then it was flat calm. It's been bright sun, so I'm really happy to have caught, really. And I'd say I've had over £10 there. They weigh well when eels do, good weight. And them two perch would be just over £1, so that's good. Wow, that's been all right, really. I was off expecting not to get a bite, so I'm really pleased with them eels. I don't mind them when they're that size, really. And if you think them couple that were 2.5 down the piece, so I mean, they're probably about 20 to 30 years old, they are. And then I've had one that would be £2, £1.5, and then £1, so I mean, you know, the good weight builders if you can get them in a match, them eels are. And then I've had the two perch for, they'd be just over £1 between them, they would. Right, so yeah, not a bad weight on a tough day, that. So really pleased with that. Anyway, thanks everybody for watching. Thanks for subscribing. And as always, take care of yourselves. Look, be safe and enjoy your fishing. Bye for now. Bye, guys. Bye.